Welcome to the Edward Hunter Heritage Bush Reserve. This is a stunning place that's got so, it's just a little hidden gem. There's some beautiful walking tracks here to go through to relax and enjoy. This morning is absolutely fabulous. It's just so still and quiet. So we're gonna have a walk along the paths here, show you what's around, and also talk about AI, what it is, what it isn't, how it can help your business. So let's go for a walk and check it out. There's a lot of confusion out there as to what AI actually is. And I want to go back and do a little bit of a history lesson, because we look at advancements in technology in different ways, and normally it comes down to the label that we apply to it. An example, if we go back to the 70s, we had, you know, the transistor. Well, the transistor was around well before that, but it was when the transistor really took hold, and we had the Tronics era. Then we moved forward and we had the integrated circuit, which led to the PC era. Then we moved into the internet era. And as we move forward with technology, it helps to have a label to actually market the stuff. But generally, what we're talking about with AI is just a further advancement of technology in a way that we can use it. It's similar now, if you want to research something, how many people would not go to a computer and type something into a search engine and find research that way? And all AI is a more in-depth way of computing and using technology to help us move forward, which is a really important point distinction to make. So it becomes the label that we use to identify a stage that we've moved through. And AI, in a way, is very similar to that. It's just a step that we've gone through, an advancement in computing power, and which they've labeled AI. The other point that's probably useful to understand is what AI is not. Now, obviously, you've seen a lot of the talk out there about AI taking over the world and, you know, Terminators and all that kind of thing. And certainly, I mean, maybe sometime in the far distant future, that might be a possibility. But as it currently stands, it's just, it is not something. And to highlight my point, my cameraman, who has some sophisticated AI in him, didn't detect the branch that was right there in front of him, and the recording stopped. So to think that AI is going to rise up and enslave us or cause us to be extinct, certainly in our lifetime, is not going to happen. One of the key reasons that's not going to happen is energy. AI takes a tremendous amount of energy. And to put that in context as to how much energy is needed, one AI server, there's some servers being built, one of those AI servers, the energy that's needed for that is in the area of 10,000. See, I've got to be careful here because I've still got to think for my camera person. The energy needed is 10,000 megawatts for one AI server. How much is that? Well, the state of Victoria uses roughly on average between 7,000 and 8,000 megawatts. So you're talking one AI server requiring the electricity, more electricity than the entire state of Victoria in Australia. And that's just a massive amount of energy that we simply cannot produce, especially given our current path. It's not physically possible at all to produce that kind of electricity without doing much devastation to the planet. That's another story. So fearing AI, and I guess that comes down to all things with change as well. When change comes along, when the internet came along, there was fear about, you know, how that would affect the world. When computers come along, again, fear. And it's just because we don't know, and it's a natural instinct to fear that. But on the plus side, there are many, many ways that AI can help us, and that's what we're here to talk about Must say, I'm really surprised by this reserve. Just walking through here, the more I walk around, the more I see, and I just really think it's such a beautiful place, especially on a day like today where there's no wind. It is so quiet and still. It's such a tranquil, peaceful place to be. Anyway, we're talking about AI and how we can use that to our advantage. In business, well, and this is one of the things we look at it and go, well, today, how would we operate without the internet? Would you use, you know, could you operate your business without using computers? And you couldn't. And there's things that, you know, if we want to find something, as I mentioned before, we do research, we'll get onto a search engine, we'll type our question in, we'll have a whole list of things that we need to search through and documents to read. Whereas with AI, what you can do, especially if you've got an AI that's connected to the internet, you can actually put that into a cert AI engine, say, can you find documents relating to this? So rather than you having to read it, it will find them for you, which makes it a lot easier.
A weird dog.
Yeah, it is a weird dog. How are you this morning?
Hi,
well. Yeah, well, thank you. And so, using that as a search engine tool is really, really helpful, because what it'll do, if you have access, the AI bot that you're using has access to the internet, you can put in, can you find articles relating to this topic? And it'll find them, give you a summary of them if you ask it to, and then give you the link so you can check that as well. And that's something to always remember. It doesn't matter. And people say, oh, you know, don't trust it, it's not, you know, and you don't trust anything that, you know, you find on the internet. Always verify the source. So that's one way you can use it. It just saves significant amount of your time. If you're looking for information, if you're doing research on, you know, markets where you want to promote your business, you can put that into a search engine or a search bot, one that has access to the internet, ask it that question, can you find research data in respect of this customer demographic? And it'll find it for you. Whereas if you put that into a standard search engine, you've got to go through and read all the articles and try and find what works and what doesn't work. Just going to stop here to give you a view. This is an absolutely stunning view. I mean, look out over here. It's quite amazing. The forest. I just wanted to show you what that looks like. You've got all the down there. There's a little valley. This is just stunning and beautiful. The other thing that you can use AI chatbots for, because they are designed around writing. And so in business, we have to deal with a number of different situations, sometimes some very delicate situations, which often involves writing letters, and it can lead to notices of dispute, those kind of things. And how you frame those things can make a big difference to the outcome that you're seeking. I mean, ideally, you don't want to escalate the situation. So you're looking for to frame things in a way which is going to help resolve resolve the situation. And that's where you can use an AI bot to really help you, because what you can do is you frame, you know, put the situation that you want to, the outcome that you want to achieve. There we have another example of how AI is not going to take over the world just yet. You just did not see stuff. Anyway, so you structure your, you say, okay, this is what I want to achieve. You've got that, you've got the situation, you've got the letter that you've written. Now what you do is you put that into an AI bot and say, this is what I want to achieve. Got this situation, I've got this dispute, and this is my letter I've drafted to address the situation. Can you provide me with feedback and any suggested improvements? And very quickly, it will go through that. So it becomes a coach in a way. It'll give you lots of suggestions. Now, this isn't to say thinking for you. Don't ever let any technology think for you. You still got to think for yourself. But what it'll do is reframe and go, well, this part here is a bit weak. This part here might inflame the situation. And it'll give you that feedback. So it's like having a coach for free, that will give you advice as to how to better frame the position that you're putting forward. So that's one way you can use that in business. And the less disputes you get into in business, the less costly things are for you. There's a couple of really nice spots to sit and rest here as you're walking. But the other thing I like here, which is so beautiful, and maybe it comes back to my childhood running around in the bush, but all these ferns that are here, just beautiful. Especially on a morning like today where there's a little bit of dampness, they're green. Just feels really fresh and lovely. I just really wanted to share that with you because it's marvelous to take in the wonderfulness of nature that we have. The other thing you can use the AI bots for is as an assistant to help you brainstorm. So you might have some things that you want to do. You might go, well, I want to try some different sales ideas. But you're not sure what they are. So you go, well, this is what I want to achieve. So you write that out and you work out what is your objective, what you're trying to achieve. And then what you do is then you put that into an AI chatbot and say, I want to achieve some marketing and I want to use a flyer to try and reach more leads. What are different ways that I can reach out to people to do that? And it'll do that for you. So previously what you would do is you put that kind of thing into a search engine, or you would get an expert salesperson in to help you out with that. Whereas what you can do is now you can use the AI bot to put that question in. I just find it very ironic in this walk. Watch what's going to happen here. Clearly AI is not going to take over the world. The irony is, out of all the filming that I've done so far, when I'm talking about AI, this is where it's failed the most. I love the irony. But what you can do is you can use the chatbot. You have a query about something, you can brainstorm. So you treat it as, like, normally in business, you would have a brainstorming session, which is actually quite time intensive to get people around the table, thrash things out, work things out to try and find a solution. Whereas with a chatbot, you can just put that into the chatbot, that query, and say, this is when, can you give me some ideas? Can you give me a list of ideas? And it'll rattle off in a few seconds a whole list of ideas, which then you've got that to choose from to help you then move forward. And it do that really, really quickly. So rather than having, you know, it might be a half an hour or an hour meeting, brainstorming session, you can put that query into a chatbot and it'll give you a whole list of things to help you move forward. It can help in many different ways like that. So hopefully that's been helpful. And there's so many different ways that you can use AI bots to help you. And one of those, I'm just stopping because I know it's going to crash again in a minute. It's just not, let's see if we can get it through. Oh, can we make it? Can we make it? It did. How cool is that? It's not going to make this one though. Oh, it did. Oh, hello. Still recording? Keep going. Hello. Let's try again. Hopefully you're having fun with that because I'm enjoying it. But I'm definitely not fearful of AI taking over the world anytime soon. But there are so many different ways you can use AI bots to help you. And it's just a more advanced search engine it's probably not doing it justice, and some AI people will probably get upset with that. But it's really just an advancement in the technology that enables you to actually do things more effectively. Some things more effectively, because I didn't like that at all. So hopefully that's helpful for you. There are lots of different ways you can use AI bots to help you and help your business to be more profitable, much more efficient, better culture to work in. So enjoy. Thank you for sharing time with me here at the Edward Hunter Heritage Bush Reserve. It's such a beautiful place to get down and have a walk and take care of your mental health. And don't worry about the AI bots taking over. I'm here at the corner of Coral Fern Walk and Wallaby Rise. So Wallaby Rise goes up this way, which I'm not going to do because I'm going to breathe. But I just wanted to show you this other side. If you come around this way and look at the ferns out here. It looks absolutely stunning. I love this look of these ferns. It's beautiful. And it's so still this morning. So wonderful and relaxing to just enjoy nature, make the most of it. I'm thinking about Wallaby Rise, but I'm not going to go up there. I'll do that another time. I just wanted to show you this. It's stunning. We do have so many wonderful things around here to enjoy. So make the most of it while you can. So we're here by the lake. And it's interesting, the town is just there. Yet it is so quiet and peaceful here. You can hear the birds singing. So literally just over that way, there's houses just over those trees over there. Just over those trees, there's houses. And right here, in the heart of this forest, it's just so peaceful and quiet. You got the ducks on the lake. So it's not hard to get out and just enjoy. I'm gonna come through here, down by the water. So just little, I had to duck my head so I can hit it. But I can hear the ducks out there. It's really cool. Check this out. The duckies. What a stunning morning. It's so quiet, peaceful. And the lake. And the reflection, it's how still it is. And the ducks are creating some ripples. But you can see the reflection. How cool is that? Look at that. Look at that view. I mean, how amazing is this? I love the green of the ducks at the top. Green's my favorite color, so that's probably why I like it. Yeah, we do live in a really, really wonderful world. It's amazing.